You may have read my article on Bowman Ales, an award-winning microbrewery from Hampshire, founded by Martin Roberts and Ray Page. After 4 years of hard work perfecting their beers and spending a lot of money on top-of-the-range equipment, they seem to have found the perfect formula for a fantastic beer. They claim you can't just make a great beer, it takes a lot of hard work and you have to buy the right equipment. Doing it on the cheap is simply not an option.
Alright, I've got bloody work here. Fuck!
I automatically thought, how hard can it be? And came up with a challenge to put to Martin and Ray's philosophy. I've ordered my very own microbrewery online. It's cost me £30, the cheapest I could find, and it'll be with me in 2 working days. I'm then going to start making my very own beer in my bedroom. I'm then going to put it against some of the top brands that you can find in supermarkets across Britain today. To do that, I'm going to get together a panel of everyday beer drinkers and see if they can pick out my beer from a selection of beers that I give them to try. Then, we will see if it is impossible or not to make a great beer on the cheap.
Here it is, the Bruiser Brewery, the world's smallest microbrewery. Simple, quick, stress-free, and above all else, cheap. All I have to do is follow 6 simple steps, and in 10 minutes, my beer will be brewing.
Now I simply wait 21 days as my beer brews. Here it is, day 7, so I'm a third of the way through. It's basically just looked like this for 7 days, sitting in the big tub. Here we are, 14 days in now. I've moved it to a different location, it's a bit cooler in here. For some reason I thought that might help. It was also starting to smell a little bit. My room's starting to smell this. But more of the same, just sitting, watching, waiting. And in 7 days' time, it'll be ready. Today is the day. 21 days have passed of my beer just sitting in there and me waiting. And today we will put it up against some other beers and see if it can prove Martin and Ray's theory wrong and highlight the fact that a good beer can be made on the cheap. These are the 4 beers that my ale will be going up against. It's Nuts by the Hampshire Bowman, one of the Bowman ales. Quiver Bitter, another Bowman ale. And then we've got the 2 popular chain supermarket brands that you will find, Newcastle Brown Ale and Hobgoblin.
Hello, what's your name? Is it
Danny?
We say you're an everyday beer drinker.
I'm an everyday beer drinker, yeah.
Very suitable for our panel. If you'd like to take a seat and just don't look at those drinks in front of you. I'm just going to shut the door because we've got no big time. Right, test today is to see if you can pick out my beer from these 5 beers. We've got a water this there, so plenty of time. Basically, I want you to give a rating out of 10 for every single one you drink, and then see if you can identify which number you can smell. But I'm going to blindfold you because I don't want you to be able to see, because this is a test on the taste and the quality of the taste of the beer, rather than how they look and smell and all that.
Okay.
But if it's covering your eyes, it should look like it is.
Yeah.
Are you ready for your first beer, sir?
I am.
Okay, this is number 1.
Hostage.
Could you please give us a summary of your results?
I thought beer 4 was the nicest. I gave that an 8.
I really enjoyed beer 1. Beer 5 was my favourite one. I gave it a very high 9 out of 10.
I thought beer 3 was the best. I gave it another 9.
My highest scoring beer was beer number 5, which I gave 6.5.
So which one did you think was Ali's beer?
Beer 2.
Same as Tego, I also think beer 2 is your beer. There was just something about it, it had a little kick of, I don't know, it was...
Shitness.
I thought your beer was beer numero 2.
And I believe yours is number 2.
I chose beer number 3, and on reflection, I regret this decision.
Okay, so last place was beer number 2, and all but one of you, who was Jake, thought it was my beer, but Jake now thinks it's my beer on reflection. I can tell you that number 2 was... my beer! Coming in second to last place was beer number 4, which was actually Hobgoblin. Third place was, quite a lot of people have been saying a lot of great things about this beer. This one came third. There was only 2 points from being the best beer, and that one was not that one. The Quiver from the Bowman Ales. Quiver. Second place, beer number 5, which Danny T here gave a 9 out of 10. The 35.5 points, beer 5 was nuts. The winner, as you all know, beer number 3, was Newcastle Brown Ale, or Nuki Brown. So, on reflection, perhaps it is true, my friends, that you cannot make good beer on the cheap. My first pound microbrewery seems to have failed me as it has come last behind two of the Bowman Ales and two ales bought in supermarkets around Britain. So, Martin and Ray, you're one up on me as a member, but I'm going to come back stronger next year. So thank you very much, lads, for joining us, and see you next.